Yeah, hello everybody. Thank you, Antonio, for the short introduction. I'm happy to be here, and I'm happy that you are here as well after the great conference dinner yesterday. I will talk today about improving publication processes of the Association for Digital Humanities in the German-speaking area. More precisely, I will talk about the work of the DHd Data Steward and the community-driven task force, DHd Abstracts. And I will do that also on behalf of my colleagues, Anke Debbeler and Rebekka Borges. So to set the scene, I'm talking to you today as the DHd Data Steward, which is a position that was established in 2020 with the goal to develop a common research data strategy for the association, with the main objectives to improve the publication strategy of the DHd conference abstracts for the sustainable provision of DHd conference websites, and also for the management of documents and outputs of the association. And of course, one objective is the community involvement, so to let the community of the DHd association participate in these objectives. And today I will talk about, especially about the improvement of the publication strategy and the community involvement. So the DHd Association was founded in 2012. It is the association for the German-speaking area, so mostly for Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. And right now we have around 440 members. Since 2014, we have an annual DHd conference, which is organized by the association and also in cooperation with different local organizers. We have an average of around 130 abstracts per conference in the presenting formats, lecture, panel, workshop, poster, and since 2022, also doctoral consortium. Since 2015, the local organizers of every DHd conference have produced a book of abstracts, a print version and a PDF version, so a digital version. And you see the book of abstracts, and to say it with the words of Patrick Sahle, if you want to understand what the digital humanities is about, what the state of the art is, what the important research topics are, you should look into the book of abstracts, not only of the DHd conferences, but of all DH conferences as well. But let's start from the beginning. Since 2016, we implemented the DH Convalidator in the submitting process of the conferences. So the workflow submitting process is quite equal to the process for the DH conferences. Authors have to create a submission in the conf tool and enter there some metadata, like the title of their submission, author names. We implemented ORCID IDs, and we're using also the Tadira taxonomy to tag the abstracts. Then a template needs to be generated through the DH Convalidator, which is containing all the metadata from the conf tool, and then the authors can write their abstracts, preferably in the template already. When they finished writing their abstracts, they have to process this template again through the DHd Convalidator, and the output is a DHC file, you all know that, which is containing an HTML version of the abstract, an XML or TXML version of the abstract, of course a template file as well, and images if they were used in the abstract. And this DHC file in the end needs to be uploaded in the conf tool again. So the output of this submitting process is that we have TRXML files, and these files are the basis for the creation of the book of abstracts. Because also, like for DH conferences, for the DHD conferences, the local organizers produce the book of abstracts through a script-based solution. I think this is the scripts were originally developed for producing the book of abstracts for the DH conference 2013. This is mostly XSRT and some shell scripts. But before doing that, because of the data is still quite messy, even though it was produced or processed through the Convalidator, the local organizers always have to do a lot of data cleaning before they can produce the book of abstracts. And sometimes the local organizers already published also the TXML files through GitHub for reuse. So the output of this process is that we have a persistently citable collection of all presented abstracts of every single DHD conference. But there are things to improve, we thought, because there is only this collection. There's no possibility to individually cite all the individual abstracts. In addition, no indexing of the abstracts in digital catalogs is possible, and because not every local organizer or all local organizers have published also the TXML files, for example, through GitHub, there is no comprehensive use of the abstracts also as research data. And this is the point where the work of the DHd Data Steward started, always in close cooperation with the local organizers of the DHd conferences. We developed the workflow for publishing all abstracts of the DHd conferences, also as distinct publications. So what have we done? The first step was that we wrote a script, or we had developed a script that is based also on the script that we are using for producing the book of abstracts to generate individual PDF files for each conference abstract. This script, as well as all other scripts that I'm talking about today, are available on GitHub as well. So this is the first step. The second one is we have some pre-processing steps. So we are creating an XML file that consists of all the metadata that we need to publish the book of abstracts on Zenodo, because all the book of abstracts were already published on Zenodo, so we decided to also publish all the individual abstracts on Zenodo. And all this metadata we get from the TXML files. Here you can see which metadata we are using. So we have, of course, the names of the authors, the affiliation, the ORCID, a description, but also information about the conference where an abstract was submitted. And then the third step is that we are creating bundles for each conference abstract. So the starting point is that we have the following folder structure. We have the metadata file, which is an XML. That consists all the metadata for one conference. Then we have two folders, one with all the PDF files, the individual PDF files, and one with the TXML files. And through a Python script, which is also available through GitHub, on GitHub, we automatically map then the metadata with both the PDF files and the TXML files. And then we have bundles for every single abstract, which consists of the JSON file, where the metadata can be found for this specific abstract, and the PDF and the TXML file. In addition, through this process, we produce a CSV file, which is containing all the mappings from the metadata and the files, and then we do a manual checking of this CSV file to check if there are any mistakes. If there are mistakes, we normally do a manual correction of the metadata and start the process again. If there are no mistakes found, then the creation process of the bundles is successfully completed. The last step of the workflow is that we then automatically publish each conference abstract on Zenodo. So again, we're using a Python script for that, and we're using the REST API of Zenodo. So we have, again, the starting point. Now we have the folder structure of the bundles, and through the Python script, we can automatically upload the bundles. So then every abstract with a TXML file and the PDF file and the metadata is uploaded on Zenodo as a draft. Then again, we do a manual checking of these drafts and look if there are any mistakes. And we check if there are mistakes, are there systematic mistakes or individual mistakes? If they're kind of systematic, then we automatically delete all the files again, and then we correct the metadata locally and start the process again. If there are only individual mistakes, we do it on Zenodo, directly on Zenodo in the drafts. And after that, we can push a button and automatically publish all the drafts. After that, again, we download the metadata that we were using for publishing the abstracts on Zenodo. This is, again, a CSV file for documenting the process, and then the publication process is successfully completed. In addition, we also create an individual GitHub repository for each DHD conference. This is containing all the TXML files, the PDF files, and the metadata we were using for publishing the abstracts, and a comprehensive README file to make especially the TXML files on the metadata reusable for research. So this is addressing the aspect that we would like to have these abstracts also used as research data. Then we push this GitHub repository also to Zenodo, just to have another copy, another version that is citable of this repository. And the third and the last step is that we also archive the GitHub repositories through the archiving workflow of the Data Center for the Humanities at the University of Cologne. So that the GitHub repositories are archived on tape storage institutionally, and this is a cold archiving process, which means that the data is not accessible, but it is findable because we are publishing the metadata of this archival package through our institutional website. With this process, we were able to publish 1,207 abstracts via Zenodo, and since 2022, we also added the poster presentations to this workflow, so we were also able to publish 109 poster presentations via Zenodo in the DHd community on Zenodo. We also have 9 GitHub repositories containing the TXML files, the PDF files, and the metadata. 8 of these repositories were already pushed to Zenodo, and these 8 repositories were also archived through the code archiving process of the DCH. And since then, all of these conference abstracts are indexed in the Digital Bibliography and Library Project, as well as in the Index of Digital Humanities Conferences. We were also able to reuse this workflow already for other conferences. So, for example, there was the VDHD conference in 2021, which was, through the pandemic, a community-driven conference online of the DHD Association. We published all the abstracts that were submitted there as well. And we were able to use this workflow for publishing all the abstracts that were submitted for the Folger Conference 2021, which is a German-speaking conference on research data management in the humanities. And as you might already have noticed, we also were able to publish all 367 conference abstracts of the DH Conference 2023 this year as distinct publications in the ADHO community of Zenodo. So just take a look in this community and you will find your abstract also published individually. And after the conference, of course, we will publish also the poster presentations. We will create the GitHub repository that will contain all the data and the files, and then we will push that to Zenodo again and archive that through the code archiving process of the DCH. Nevertheless, there are still things to improve with regard to especially the abstracts seen as research data, and that is why we introduced the DHD Task Force, DHD Abstracts. It was established in 2022. It's a problem-oriented group of volunteers, and it consists of different members of the DHD community, like scholars, former DHD conference organizers, developers, librarians, so we have different point of views on this publication process and on the abstracts as research data. Currently, we have 11 members in this task force, and we are organized in regular meetings, and I think in the end of August, we will have our first hackathon in person to work on the publication process and on the scripts. So what are the potentially improvements that we are addressing, that we are working on? First of all, we already worked on the documentation of the submitting process. As you all know, we have with the DHCon validator and the conf tool two tools that need to be used for the submitting process of conference abstracts. This can be sometimes a little bit tricky. The conf validator can be a little bit tricky to use. So what we wanted to do is to raise awareness for this process, document this process, raise awareness for this process, because the idea behind the DHCon validator is, of course, to produce more or less clean TXML files. So what we have done is we wrote some guidelines for the submitting process, which is also published on Zenodo. So this is the first step, or the first thing we have done. The second point we're addressing are inconsistencies in the TXMLs. So as I already told you, the local organizers have to do a lot of data cleaning before They are able to process the TXML files for producing the 5 minutes, thank you, for producing the book of abstracts. This can be because of wrong formatting that is done by the authors, because they probably, and we all do that, I do that as well, different text editors for writing the abstracts, and then we are all copying probably the text into the template. Then there are some formatting information that that are not deleted, and they are then part of the TXML, or there can be wrong template configurations, so the data is not as clean as it should be. So this is a point we are also working on. We wrote a blog article about the submission process and tried to give some advices for authors how they should write or which tools they should write their proposals, their abstracts, for the conferences to avoid these mistakes. And in addition, we are working on an analysis of frequent mistakes in the TXML files in order to develop strategies to avoid them or prevent them in the future. We also having a closer look on the integration of more authority data to the files, because when we provide these files as research data, they should be analyzable, of course. We are, as I already told, using authority data, we are using the ORCID IDs, we are working with the Tadira taxonomy, but we found out that there's a very, very big problem in the use of affiliations in the abstracts. So this is, there's no authority data that is used for naming the affiliations of the authors. So we are also analyzing the used affiliations through the last years in order to develop a definite list and of these affiliations, and we would like to make this list available for authors so they can just use use a specific version of their affiliation. We would like to map that also with existing standards like the Research Organization Registry or the Gemeinsame Normdatei, which is a German-based authority database, to make the XML TI or the TXML files more analyzable. And the last thing is what we are looking for, or what we think, is that there's even more room for fundamental improvements because of all the things I already showed. So what we are also doing is we are evaluating alternative software for the submitting process, for example, the Fidus Writer, which could probably produce better, cleaner TXML, so that the on the one hand, the submitting process is more easy for the authors, and on the other hand, that there are not so much things that need to be cleaned in the TXML files for the local organizers. And there's the last thing I just added yesterday, so I forgot that. We are also working on aligning the processes of producing the book of abstracts and the distinct publications of the abstracts. Right now, we are working closely together with the local organizers, of course, but the processes are kind of parallel, although we are using the same script based, and we are working on aligning that so that the communication between the data steward team and the local organizers can be improved as well. So here's some take-home messages. We are convinced that individual publications of DH conferences, conference abstracts, can improve the work quality of the whole community, but on a structural level and on an organizational level, though, there are still a lot of things to improve, and we are convinced that this should be done community-driven, because all the difficulties and the potential improvements within this context address the needs of the community itself and should be then also addressed by the community. Yeah, that was it. Thank you very much. If you are interested in the slides, I have published them already, and I'm happy to hear questions. Thank you.